Today is my video on complex number, that is from class 11. And now we discussed in previous video about the imaginary numbers. Imaginary numbers in particular denoted by the iota and describe the property related to the iota, iota equal to under root minus 1. And we said that square root of any negative real number is called imaginary number, and it is denoted by the iota because this iota introduced by the Euler, and so many properties are described in the previous video, like I square, I cube, I to the power 4, and I to the power 4 is 1, and then how we identify or evaluate, suppose some higher power, maybe large exponent terms are given there, then how you reduce your in terms of iota and then simplify the results. So in previous video I explained all these things. So today I again introduce the same thing, like imaginary quantities. Imaginary quantity, it means again the definition is same, because in the 10th class we study like quadratic equation, in which we use formula like x equal to minus b plus minus under root b square minus 4ac upon 2a, and now this inside value is denoted by d, and that is b square minus 4ac. Okay, and now here we find out there are three nature of this value. Okay, so we introduce like d greater than 0, d equal to 0, and d less than 0. So d less than 0, it means your square root term, inside a square root you have the negative number, negative real number, and then how you simplify your negative real number. Okay, so in this video especially we discuss about the imaginary numbers. So this case here we discuss. Okay, then like we have under root minus 1, we have minus 2, minus 4, okay, minus 9, and so on. These all numbers, they are the line belong to d less than 0 because inside value is negative. And then in previous video I introduced under root of minus 1. Under root of minus 1 you define by I, and I here denoted like iota, and iota is an imaginary number. Okay, so iota is an imaginary number, so it is denoted by this one. And now you have under root minus 2. Then how you simplify under root minus 2? So you add on like minus 2, which is under root 2 into under root minus 1. So this is nothing, only under root 2i. Okay, any negative real number inside a square root, then how you simplify with respect to iota? So only you differentiate with the minus sign here, like minus 2, then you first this thing is like 2 and minus 1 in the different form. Like we have the same here, under root minus 4, and then minus 4 you denote like under root 4. And now under root minus 1, so this is under root 4 is 2, and under root minus 1 is I, so answer is 2i. Okay, similarly same thing here, under root minus 9, now minus 9 and under root minus 1, and under root 9 is 3, and under root minus 1 is I. Okay, so if negative number inside a square root term, then how you simplify in terms of I? Because basically other than the relation of the iota we defined in the previous video, but in this video I especially discussed about the imaginary quantities. So in imaginary quantities there are so many questions, in which like here we discuss, suppose root at under root minus a, under root minus b, which is minus of under root ab. Okay, then that is very simple, it is because minus under root a minus under root b in the same way here we define, when you add on the LHS part, you have under root minus a and under root minus b. Okay, so since first here we simplify under root minus a, and we differentiate this term minus and a. So first here we write down under root a into under root minus 1, and we know that under root a is under root a, but under root minus 1 especially that is denoted by I. And similarly again you simplify the under root minus b, under root minus under root b into under root minus 1, so you have under root of b into I. Okay, then you put the value of under root minus a, which is under root a I, and here under root b I. Okay, so I square and under root a into under root b, and under root this is I square, so minus 1, and under root a into b is under root ab, so it is defined by minus ab. Okay, so which is the RHS part? In this video, we define especially about the under root minus a into under root minus b, because I square also defined in the previous video, because all properties related to the iota we defined in the previous video. But in only in particular this video we define the imaginary quantities, and we discuss about the some examples they are related with the like this type of imaginary numbers, and they how you simplify like this, and according to the like you directly multiply, then you got the under root ab only. No, but first you simplify the first bracket and then you simplify the second bracket and then write down in this way, because you have a imaginary quantity multiplied by the imaginary quantity, then resultant value not always may be imaginary, may be real, may be imaginary, depending on the case. But in this particular, we have a particular arbitrary numbers like a and b, and then we define the concept. Okay, similarly, so for example, like same here we discuss example 1, because this is a theorem, and now we have under root minus 4 and now under root of minus 5. Okay, so same, this is the same variety of the question are here. So again, now we have simplified. You have under root minus 4, then minus 4, first you separate out under root 4 and then you separate with minus 1, because minus sign you separated with the different like separate square root sign here. And now 5 minus 1, again you differentiate like 5 and then minus 1 separately. And what do you mean by under root minus 1? Because here we discuss like same under root minus 1, always here we denote it by the iota, and it is denoted by iota, so we define this term with respect to iota, and we know that under root minus 4. Under root minus 4 is 2, and this term is I, so 2i. And similarly here under root 5, and now I again, so we have I square and 2 under root 5, so answer is minus 2 root 5. Now it is real, because both numbers are imaginary, but their resultant term in form of the real numbers, like one theorem here we done, then one more examples that is related with the same. And now again here we take the different variety of equations and different examples with the. Okay, again we have the different variety of equations related to the same. You simplify the imaginary quantities, because all these equations they are related with the imaginary quantities, because all square root having the minus sign, and then how you simplify the minus sign. Okay, so first equation we have like first we solve the first part like under root of minus 196. Okay, then first you differentiate minus sign and the quantity, so under root 196 and now under root minus 1. Okay, so you write down under root 196, that is the square root of 14, and now this quantity is I, so your answer is under root 14i. Okay, similarly we have same again here, like second question, under root of minus 144. Okay, so 144 again you add on with the different form, like 144 is a separate term, and into under root minus 1 you separate with the minus sign. Always this concept is belong on the minus sign. Minus sign is separated by the real number. Okay, so we have again, we know that 144 is the 12, and this value is denoted by iota, so it's simplified by iota, and then you got the value of 12i. Okay, similarly we have two terms here, like number 3, like under root of minus 9, and here we have under root of minus 25 by 4. Okay, this is nothing, only you separate out with the minus sign, so under root 9, under root minus 1, and 25 by 4, and similarly under root of minus 1. Okay, so under root minus under root 9 is 3, and this is I. Similarly 25 is a 5, and now this is a 2, and then I. Okay, so 3 5 is a 15, 15 by 2 I square, and I square is a minus sign, so minus 1 and then 15 by 2, so now it is a real number, because both these two questions they are related to the imaginary, because their answer will be in form of iota, but this question having two terms, and now here we simplify it. and the resultant term like minus 15 by 2 is a real number. Okay, the same question is here fourth. Again we have under root minus 25 minus 9 by 49, and then again now here we separate like 25 into under root minus 1, and here the same 9 by 49 and under root minus 1. Okay, so 25 is a 5, and this again under root minus 1 you define by I, and 9 that is a square root of 3, and 49 is square root of 7, and now under root of minus 1 is I. Okay, I that is I square, and 5 is a 15, so 15 by 7 I square, so answer is minus 15 by 7. Okay, so again you got your answer in form of the real number. Okay, but fifth part is differently given, because this question is not related with the in multiplication. We have the different operation like plus minus here, and now we simplify the whole question in form of iota. Okay, so this is very easy going again. Question is not mattered, only you separate the minus sign here. So 36 you separate out with under root of minus 1, and similarly 3 and under root 9 into under root minus 1, similarly 4 under root 25 and under root minus 1. You underline the minus 1 because minus 1 denoted by the iota, and now we know that under root 36 is 6, and this sign is iota, so 6i. And now we have 3, and now under root 9 is 3, and again this is iota. Similarly 4 into 5 and again iota, so your answer is 6i, 9i and 4 5 is 20i. So 6 plus 9 15, 15 plus 20 is 35, so your final resultant value is 35i. Okay, so overall simplify, then ultimately you got the answer, your answer in form of the imaginary numbers, because your answer in form of I, and I is iota, and iota is an imaginary number. So last part we have here 6, so this is part 6, and then again we have minus 3 by 2, under root minus 4, plus 7 by 3, under root of minus 9, minus 16 by 5, under root of minus 25. So after simplify, again we write down the separate with the minus sign, under root minus 4 and under root minus 1, and similarly 7 by 3, under root 9 and under root of minus 1, minus 16 by 5, and again you write down here 25, and again you write down minus 1. So again you surround with the circle this under root minus 1, because we know that minus 1 is iota, and now we have minus 3 by 2 into 2i, plus 7 by 3 into 3i, and now minus 16 by 5, and now again this is 5, so 5i. 5 5 cancel out, this 3 3 cancel out, 2 2 cancel out, you have minus 3i plus 7i, and now here minus 16i. Okay, so overall minus 3 and minus 16, that is minus 19, and but plus 7, so you have 12i. Your answer again in form of the imaginary, and now this is the very simplified form, because all questions now here you do like in form of the imaginary numbers, but one thing is common, all numbers they are given in the inside square root sign is negative, because our basic motto according to our topic, imaginary quantities, imaginary quantity, it means you consider a square root in which negative real numbers you have, and negative real number in with a square root sign, that is a imaginary numbers. And now so many examples we solve, and then simplify the questions, and then find out the solutions. Okay, how you simplify if your question is like in this form, and then your answer you convert into the form of I. One theorem also here we did, like under root of minus A, under root of minus B, and then the simplified form is under root of minus AB. So this is very easy going, no so much lengthy operations are here. because they are all related with the previous class, and now square root we know very well because this is relation with the search, like you study in the 9th class, and this quadratic equation related, that is also you study in the 10th class. So now I think this chapter is very very easy, and now you do the more practice on the basic basis of the real negative real numbers, and now square root of negative real number is the imaginary quantities. So now in the next video, we simplify like operation on the complex number. So this particular video is related with the only imaginary quantities, but in the next video we have a operation on the complex number.